Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG and SQL sample video. Today I'd like to show you how you can create a trigger in SQL. You already know that it is possible to create it in RPG, but I think it is interesting to see that in SQL it is even simpler than in RPG. So let's go. As an example, we are going to create a small table where we are going to save the users who have modified or deleted records from a specific file. We are going to do this using a trigger, of course. So let me create the table. As always, we are going to use the run SQL script utility. User history, for example. As you know, if you are using directly tables in SQL, the name of the tables can be more than 10 characters length. We are going to have a timestamp. The username is going to be a character field of 10 positions, and the operation that will be a D for delete and a new if it is an update. Okay. Well, let me run this statement. Okay. So we have now my table here with no records. Okay. Well, in this table, our trigger will save the timestamp of the operation, the user, and whether the operation was a delete or an update. Okay. Well, now let's go with the trigger. We are going to do it in SQL, so we will use the same screen. What we have to do is this: create or replace trigger. Okay, let me move this. Okay, now we have to write here the moment where the trigger is going to run. Okay, after delete or update on, and now the table where we are going to put the trigger. We are going to use this table, games, for each row, mode db2 row, begin and end. Okay, well, as we are going to do it after delete and after update, we are going to have if deleting, then end. If, and if updating, then end if. Okay. What we are going to do when it is when we are deleting, we are going to insert into this table user history values. We are going to insert the current timestamp, the current user, and we are going to insert a D. Okay? Well, we are going to do the same in the other place in updating. Okay? But we are going to put here an U. Okay? Well, it is as easy as this. And if I run this, okay, the trigger is created and assigned to the indicated table, this one. So if we want to see it, we can go to the green screen and see games with the option number 5. And we can look for the triggers, and you can see we have the trigger user history, that is this one that I have created, okay, that is enabled, and it is going to be run after update, and also it is going to be run after delete. Okay, perfect. Well, now we just have to try it. We're going to modify a record of the file. This is my file. Okay. And we're going to modify one of these records, for example, using this. We're going to change this game 4. We're going to change it for game 5, for example. Okay. What has happened? Well, let's see our history table. And what I have there is this. As you can see, this user has made an operation of update in this date and time. Okay? So it seems to work fine. If I change it again, I put again a 4, and I see my user history file, I have another record with another update operation. Okay? Well, imagine that in addition to saving this, we want to be able to save data as it was before and as it is after. Of course, only in update operations. The first thing will be to modify our history file to save the data we want. The ideal is to disable the trigger in the meantime. You already know that to remove a trigger or put it in, we need to have the file exclusively. Let me drop it. Okay, so now we can modify it, and let's change the file. Okay, the history file. Let me drop it. Okay, and now let me create it, the new two fields that I'm going to add. As you see, my file is this one, and we want to save the name as it was before and as it is after. Okay, so we are going to add to my file, to my history, user history file, the old name. For example, and the new name. Okay, so we are going to run this. Okay, my file is created, and I'm going to recreate the trigger again to add this information. Well, we need to change this to be able to access the before and after records. We can add this. Well, this means that we can access the fields of the table using the prefix N for the new ones and the O for the old ones. Okay, so we can do this in the deleting. We can add the old name is gonna be the O dot name, and the new name is gonna be a blank. Okay, because I'm deleting. And when we are updating, we are going to add the old name and the new name this way. Okay, so let me run this statement again. Okay, the file has now the trigger, and if I change the game again as before this way, I'm going to change this game name, new game. Okay. Well, and if I see my history, my user history table, what I have is this. So this user has made an update operation this date and time, and the old name that I had in this file was the game 4. and the new name is new game. Okay, if I try it again and I put here again game 4 and I see the user history again, I have another record with the update operation and the old name and new name as it was before and as it is after. So as you can see, it works perfectly. So well, as you see, it is very easy to create triggers using only SQL without the need to program in RPG. Of course, we can add many more things to our trigger, many more. We can complicate it whatever we want, but in this case, we will have to use SQL statements only, okay? Well, I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.